On that fateful morning in the battlefield, in the Horn of Africa, the deadliest disaster occurred. In what is termed by the Defense Forces as the darkest night in the history of this East African army since independence, dozens of lives were silenced by the guns. They were caught unawares and excruciatingly blown into smithereens as majority suffered severe lifetime injuries. For the lucky few who narrowly survived, the aftermath brought them far-reaching consequences physically, emotionally, and psychologically. This is a story of a struggling soldier. When a military mind degenerates into a solitary mind, it becomes catastrophic. A mind that was professionally trained to engage in defensive and combat mode, suddenly rendered redundant. The vividly harrowing experiences of that fateful day, which orchestrated the mental lapses and instability. Ever felt like you're a stranger within your own soul and always on the run from yourself? The only remedy to get through the days is by intoxication of that very mind, perhaps to make the nerves steady. Strangely, people's company and social interactions are no longer interesting. Worst of it all is any kind of noise or banging. This immediately triggers the fighting mode of a soldier against his deadly enemy. Noise turns him into a nasty beast, thirsty for the predator's blood. A trained soldier is supposed to be in the battlefield, if not the barracks. Letting him roam ineffectively with the civilians is dangerous, especially if he is mentally disturbed. If he cannot fight, then he will create an opportunity for one, just to feel the fulfillment of a soldier.
No, baby, I'm okay.
Babe, you need help. You need to see a psychiatrist.
Yes. I'm going to fight and stand by you, my love. The only mistake you did was to serve the nation and put your life in the line, dismissing you unceremoniously for being mentally unfit for service after the effects of the war. Look at what they have reduced you to, my husband. From a committed, dependable breadwinner to a helpless, restless man, wrestling with post-traumatic stress disorder. Nevertheless, I'm determined to help you recover to your normal state. You have always been my soldier, and I will remain to be your soldier.